In this segment, we'll talk about the pitfalls and the Gaussian method, which is a method to solve simultaneous linear equations. Let's look at the first pitfall, which is division by zero. Somebody's giving you three equations, three unknowns, which are given right here. And if you put these three equations, three unknowns in the matrix form, they will look like this. Now, if you were at the first step of fall elimination, what would happen is that you would say, okay, I'm going to choose this as my pivot element, and I want to make this 6 to be 0, and I want to make this 5 to be 0. So what you have to do is, in order to calculate the multiplier for this element to become 0, you will have to say, hey, I take multiply by 6 and divide by 0. Same thing is going to happen here. You will say, hey, I'm going to multiply by 5 and I'm going to divide by 0 here. And you can very well see that this is a big problem here, because you get division by 0 here and you get division by 0 here. So that's one of the pitfalls of Gaussian method. Let's look at another example right here. Now here we have, again, three equations, three unknowns given to us. And we are writing them in the matrix form. And people might say, hey, I don't see any division by 0 problems right here, because if I take the first step of forward elimination right here, this is 12, this is 6, and this is 5. So in order to be able to find the multiplier for this will be multiplied by 6 divided by 12. So the multiplier will be 6 divided by 12. And the multiplier for this one will be 5 divided by 12. So I don't see any division by 0 problems. But one of the things which you got to understand is that division by 0 is not necessarily to be looked at as an issue when you start your forward elimination, but at the start of every forward elimination step. So this is what you get at the end of the first step. So this is the first step of forward elimination. So if you take the first step of forward elimination, you're starting with the equations which are given to you, and you're going to end up with equations with the quotient matrix like this. Now, when you are at the second step of forward elimination, what you're going to do is you're going to choose this as the pivot element. And in order to make this to be 0, you have a multiplier of minus 21 divided by 0. So you can very well see that there also you're going to have the problem with division by 0. So you got to understand, it's a common myth among students that division by 0 is only to be looked at when you first start the forward elimination steps in a set of equations. Division by 0 has to be looked at as a possibility and a pitfall at the beginning of any step of forward elimination. So that's something which you have to be careful about when you understand what this pitfall is. So let's look at the second pitfall. We can already see that there is a problem that even if you're going to have division by 0, let's suppose you now have division by a small number, that's also going to create problems. And that gives us into what we talk about, the pitfall number 2, which is a large round of errors which we are getting here. So in the large round of errors which we have here is that this is an example given of a coefficient matrix. And this is the right-hand side vector. The exact solution which you can get by simply plugging in these values of x1 equal to 1, x2 equal to 1, and x3 equal to 1 into these equations, you are going to exactly get the right-hand side. So that is the exact solution, if not anything else. Let's go and see that if we conduct Gaussian elimination, Gaussian method, and we use a 6 significant digit computer with chopping. So what we are saying is that all calculations, intermediate as well as final, that you have 6 significant digits in your numbers with chopping, meaning that you are not the 7th number which you are getting, the 7th significant digit which you are getting, you are not using that to round off any of the numbers. This is what you get as the solution. And we already know that the exact solution is 1, 1, 1. That's exact. So that's already exact. So we are finding out that the difference between the actual solution which we are getting by using 6 significant digit chopping is very close to what is the exact solution. So we don't need to be worried about that. But let's suppose we use Gaussian method now with 5 significant digit chopping, which is a pretty reasonable computer to have. And now you are having 5 significant. That means that the 6th significant digit which you are getting, you are ignoring it. Anything after the 6th significant digit, you are ignoring it. And for all the calculations, intermediate as well as final, you're using 5 significant digits with chopping. So what you find out now is that you are getting a different solution now. This is, again, I'm going to write down the exact solution. 1, 1, 1 is the exact solution. But now you are getting a number which is very close to 1 for x3, but x of 2, you're getting 1.5. And for x of naught, you're getting x1, you're getting 0.625, which is quite far away. It's about 30% away from the exact value. So the question arises that we have two pitfalls in the Gaussian method. Is there a way to reduce round-off error or division by zero? Now, what are the possibilities? Now, what we can do is, in order to avoid the pitfalls, we can increase the number of significant digits. So if we are using single precision, we can use double precision. We can use chord precision. But what that will do is that by increasing the precision, it will decrease the round-off error. But the problem of division by zero, you cannot avoid division by zero, because whether you're using single precision or double precision, if the number is zero and dividing by zero, whether you're using single precision, double precision, or chord precision, that's not going to help you any. So that's one way to avoid one of the pitfalls. If you want to reduce the round-off error, you can increase the number of significant digits by going from single to double to chord precision. Now, the other way of avoiding the pitfall is Gaussian elimination partial pivoting, which is a separate method, which is based on the Gaussian method. Is Gaussian elimination partial pivoting, which basically what it does is avoids division by zero. If the solution is unique, then it will avoid division by zero no matter what, and then you reduce the round-off error by using the method itself. So that seems to be a good antidote to the pitfalls of a new Gaussian method. So coupled with Gaussian elimination partial pivoting, as well as increasing the number of significant digits which you are using by increasing the precision to double and chord precision, you will be able to decrease the penalty which you're going to pay for the pitfalls by having either division by zero or having large round-off error. And that's the end of this segment.